You won't believe this, but Google actually have a star guide for scripting in Bash. It goes through everything from naming conventions to comments to formatting and even aliases. But don't worry, you don't have to go through the whole thing because I've done that for you. And I'm going to go through the 10 most important takeaways from this star guide. And make sure you watch till the end because I have left the best for last. Number one, stop using Bash. Yep, that's right. You should stop using Bash right now if you have a really long script. So something above 100 lines. This is because Bash isn't great for long projects. It's difficult to maintain and debug. Instead, use something like Python, which is installed by default on all modern Linux distributions. Number two, give your script an overview. Put a comment at the top of your script right below the shebang to give a brief overview of what the script actually does. This is to explain your script's purpose to someone who's reading it for the first time. Point number three, formatting. Scripts should have two-space indentation, no tabs, and a line length of 80 characters. This is all pretty obvious, but what if you have a really long string literal? Then you should use a here document, or if you're okay with lots of backslashes in your script, you could use embedded new lines. Number four, pipelines. Don't pipe lots of commands on one line. It's really difficult to read. If you have a really short pipeline, then fine, you can leave it. But if you don't, split them up into one segment per line with the pipes at the start of a new line with two-space indentation. This also applies if you're using logical operators. Number five, always use braced variables. When referencing a variable, always use braced instead of unbraced. Braced variables are much easier to read when you're concatenating strings, they're safer to use in loops, and they're easier to debug. Only use unbraced variables for positional parameters like these, or for special variables like these. Number six, arrays. Arrays in Bash should not be used as a more complex data structure. If you want that kind of functionality, then use a language like Python. Instead, arrays should be used for more simple things, like holding some arguments for a command. It's better to use an array for something like this than to use strings, because strings just won't work. Number seven, avoid aliases. Now, I love aliases. I use them all the time in my configuration, but I won't write them in any of my scripts, because they can hide the actual command being used, which makes the script less readable. They also don't work as expected. Like in this scenario, random will only be called once when the alias is defined. So if random name is used a lot, it won't really be random. If you want to do something like this, then use a function instead. Number eight, use double brackets over single brackets. Double brackets are generally more distinct and easier to read. They also support more complex expressions like logical operators and pattern matching. But a big benefit is that they support word splitting, so this code will work as expected. But with single brackets, the shell splits the string into multiple words, so this will never work. Number nine, always declare function-specific variables as local. This is to prevent you from changing any global variables by accident, but it also makes things cleaner. Also, if you're assigning the result of a command substitution to a variable, put it on a different line from the declaration. This helps a lot with error handling, because here, if the command fails, it doesn't propagate the exit code from the command substitution, but instead contains the exit code of local. But if you write it like this, now if the command fails, you get the correct exit code. And last, but definitely not least, number 10. Drumroll please. Use ShellCheck. ShellCheck is a great way to find warnings and bugs in your script. You can use it here in the browser, you can install it using a package manager and use it in your terminal, or install it as a VS Code extension. And that's it, 10 best practices for shell scripting. If you have any more points, let me know in the comments. And if you have ideas for any future videos that you want to see from us, also put it down in the comments.